Hello InfoSec community, welcome to our new series Regex. So what is actually Regex? Regular expressions are extremely useful in extracting information from text such as any code, log file, spreadsheets, or even documents. And while there are a lot of theory behind formal language, the following lessons and example will explore more. Feeling curious, right? So let's hover around and let's see. So here comes the lesson one, ABCs. What actually we are trying to do here? There are a set of codes, set of characteristics as we can see, but we need to match, or we need to write a particular code which will match A, B, C from the above codes. Let's see how we can do that. So if we write A, B, C, only that's three, it will match those particular A, B, C from the above character sets, right? Nothing else. It's very easy. Next lesson is 1.5, that is 1, 2, 3s. So what we are trying to achieve here? There are a set of characters again, and we need to match, or we need to write a particular code that will match only 1, 2, 3 from all the above sets. Let's see how we can do that. It's again quite easy. If we can write just 1, 2, 3, it will match. Pretty simple, nothing else like the previous one. We will speed up the section and go to the next one, the dot. You remember, the dot is a kind of wild character like Joker. Joker can do anything, right? It can appear anywhere in the set of cards. So actually the same thing we are trying to achieve here. If you can see, we want to match the only the dot character from the above matches, and we want to skip where there is no dot. So if you just write dot, it will match, but it will not skip the latter one, what we actually want to skip where there is no dot. So we need to escape that. So that is the sequence, the black slash. Remember that, that is actually a escape character. Gotcha? Now we will move to our next lesson, which is matching a specific character from a particular set, we can say. So what actually we are trying to see here, or we are trying to do, we want to match the front letters, that is C, M, F, and not the latter one what we have mentioned as escape. So let's see. If we write can, it will match only the first one. If you write C, M, F, it will not match anything. What we need to do here, we need to put those words CMF into a brace, angle brace. That is the nomenclature of if you want to set or if you want to select from those characters. Nothing else. So always remember, when we are trying to set or trying to select the front letters, you need to select the front letters within brackets. Now let's see how to exclude specific characters. What we have learned, how to select a set of characters. Now we want to write a particular code that will skip something, but that will select firstly the dog and the hog, but not the bog. So we are writing in the same fashion within the braces, but we will add a tick in front of it. So that is the nomenclature if you want to exclude something from a selection. So you have noting, right? Noted down the things. Let's see. Character ranges, how to select it. Again, it's quite simple. What we want to skip is mentioned in the lower bottom section, and what we want to match is mentioned in the top of the section. So again, the angle braces. And remember, we want to select the ABCs, which is in caps. So we need to write ABC, not the small ABC, that won't match. So the regular expression is kind of character sensitive, what we can say. So that is also matching because we are escaping the one which is the lowercase and we are mentioning the tick. So it's quite similar. You can do anything, right? What actually will match to the particular character set and what doesn't match to the particular character set. So there are several kind of conversation or several kind of fashion. If you mention like that way, A to Z, that is also matching the capital letters or the capital phrases from the above. But if you mention A to Z in small, that means you are selecting A to Z. So like the similar one, if you mention a tick, that will also match. Now, if you have a scenario where you need to match A to Z in caps and A to Z in small, you need to write the above code. And if you mention tick in the between, so that will skip the second part. It will not select the A to Z in small, but it will select the A to Z in the front. And remember, slash W means any words that is in capital. So that is the reason it is not matching. Feeling overloaded? Okay, let's catch some Z now. It's quite easy. What we are trying to see here, we want to catch the number of Z's, not the last one where it has mentioned WhatsApp. So we want to skip that. Where we want to skip it, where it is a single Z, but we want to catch the all Z. So you can mention here Z plus. That means you are selecting Z and plus means multiple. Then remember that fashion where you, if you are mentioning anything apart from plus, that means it's getting duplicated. So if you are selecting the Z, we need to again the doing it the same way, like the way braces. Now this is a fashion where you want to select the particular number of Z. If you want to select 3Z, that will match within the curly brace. If you mention 2 to 4, that means 3, right? 2 to 4 is 3. So again, it will match the same kind of thing. So it is another fashion. So first portion will take the what alphabet you want to select, and the second portion will take the number of alphabets. Isn't it fun? Now we will do some wild characters. Mr. Clean. Let's see. Okay, so what we are trying to do here, we want to match first four things, but we want to skip single A. So if we write A, it will match everything. So that is not our desired code, right? If you write ABC, that is also not matching. So we want to write something what actually will skip single A, but that will match the upper match characters. So there are multiple A's, B and could be C. So ABC plus means we are selecting anything between ABC and at that could multiply, right? But is it a correct code? I don't think so. What actually we want to do? We want to skip A. So if you mention A in the curly brace, not in the curly brace, so it's a angle brace. So the previous one, 2 plus won't work. That means 2 to 4, anything between 2 to 4 and BC again in curly braces and the plus. So remember, curly brace comes when you want to match a number of character and angle brace for the particular character. Okay, next chapter is optional character. Okay, what we are trying to match here? We want to match where there is no question mark. But remember, it's a special character. So remember, in the special character like dot, you also need to escape that. So it's quite simple. worked, but it's only selecting the question mark at the bottom. But we want to select the whole characters. So let's see how we can do that. Again, braces and ABC. Remember A to Z, that will match anything. But why it is matching only D? Because of the plus sign. So if you want to select anything which is multiple characters, you need to mention plus. Now there is a space. So how you can escape that? Remember that escaping space means backslash then S. That will escape a space character. You can mention plus if you don't know how many spaces are there in between. So you can copy the same fashion and just paste in front, because that is also a word that will match that particular regular expression, right? So in front of that, you can again escape that space. So 0 to 9 means it is selecting anything which is 0 to 9. So that is a regular expression of selecting the numbers. So as we see, it is quite matching. So just pause the video and let's see. It's quite complicated, we can see, but we'll get through this. So next chapter is selecting all white spaces. As you have seen in this particular previous video or the previous session, how we can select a space is simple. Backslash then S. And if you want to select multiple space, then backslash plus. And here you want to match the character where there is space in between 1, 2, 3 and then ABC. But the skip character is 4 and ABC, so there is no match. So firstly, we will write 0 to 9 for alphabet, not digit. Then we will escape the dot. Remember, where you want to escape, just place a backslash. I hope you are catching with me, right? Because it's quite simple and it's quite regular that the previous one. If you have any query, post that in the comment. We will be happy to answer that. So next session, starting and ending. How you want to select something where there is a particular string match in the between of a sentence, in the front of a sentence, and at the very end of the sentence. This is a most important thing, so please pay attention. What actually we are trying to do here? We want to select mission successful, but not the last two. So first we need to select mission. Remember, there could be confusing. If you are selecting it within the bracket, that means you are escaping that. But if you are selecting it within the not bracket, that means you are selecting that particularly. And if you want to select something at the end, that will means you will put a dollar sign at the very end of that particular character. You can pause it and you can have a view of it. Things are getting complicated now. We will try to match the groups now. So groups means if you have a sentence and if you want to select a particular characters and if you want to that mention that into a capture group. So file record transcript.pdf, file something.pdf you want to capture, but if you want to skip .temp file. So remember, if you want to capture something, that will come into angle brace. If you write file, that means it is selecting the file. So file dot, that will capture anything apart from file. That's a wild character, right? And plus, we know already what does the plus means, but it is not actually the desired thing that we are trying to achieve. We want to skip what is dot temp. So let's see what we can do. As we have mentioned, we need to put that into an angle brace. So if you are putting something into angle brace and mentioning a tick between, in front of it, that means you want to select that and not anything else. So that is a capture group, remember that. And we will write PDF. Backslash dot is for escaping that, and backslash dot PDF is for only selecting the PDFs. And remember the dollar sign from the previous one? That is the reason, because it's the end of the character. There will be nothing else from PDF. Great, you have learned a lot of things. Now let's see the next chapter, nested groups. What we will try to see here, we will be doing groups within groups. That means there could be multiple capture groups. Previous one have single capture group. But here we want to select the date January 18, 1987, May 1969, plus the year as well. So as it is a nested capture, we will be mentioning it within two angle braces. Remember, backslash D is for digits, anything digit, anything which comes with digit, and backslash W means any words. Just remember one thing, if you want to select something within the capture group, the 0 to 9, A to Z, A to small z, that won't work. So you need to specifically select that particular phrase what matches the exact number of digits. That means backslash D, backslash W for the words and for the digits. Not bad, right? We will see something new and some more group works. Let's see. So if you have understood the very basic things, you will be easily writing this script along with us. So we want to capture 1280 and 720 both, and there is a cross between. So previous one was having two capture groups within a single one. But this is a separate capture group. So how many number of capture groups are there? You need to mention those many braces. Again, the same thing, backslash D for digits, plus for multiply. Again, backslash D for digits, plus for multiply. And you need to select a cross. That means you need to escape that. That's a special character. Got it? And as we have mentioned earlier, the backslash D will only work within the capture group and nothing else will work. Nice, right? Finally, it's final session. It's all conditional now. How you want to select a conditional phrase? There could be some scenario, right, where you want to select cats and dogs, or cats or dogs, but not the logs and the cogs. Right? So it's quite simple. Let's see how you can select a alternative. There is no rocket science of selection of the other characters, so we are simply writing the way we have explained in the previous one. So the main thing will be, we want to select cats and dogs in a single phrase. So we will mention a pipe. But if you have seen, I love cats has matched, I love dogs hasn't matched. That is the reason we need to capture that into a particular capture group. So finally we are done here. Where you can practice, there is a site, just browse that. It is mentioned in the screen, I hope you are able to see it. It's a very common platform and you can practice it over there. Now it's quiz time. We want to capture the date and the IP address. Can you write that? Mention it in our comment section. We hope this has been informative, and please like, comment, and subscribe. Stay tuned for the next one. Thank you.